All right, now let's get to the hydrodynamic nonlinear fluid extension term over here. So we'll just call this dynamic nonlinear fluid extension. And if you recall from the earlier perturbation pressure term over here, we have del squared P prime NL. We'll call this FE to refer to the fluid extension. And that's going to be equal to a bunch of other terms, minus rho naught times partial U prime partial X squared plus partial V prime partial Y squared plus partial W prime partial Z squared plus dot, dot, dot. And since we're squaring each of these perturbation terms over here, these derivatives, horizontal and vertical derivatives of the perturbation velocity terms over here, this quantity over here is always going to be positive. And so if we consider this term over here, again being P prime NLFE, with the del squared operator being treated as a negative sign as we take two derivatives over here, the negative signs cancel out, and so we have P prime NLFE is equal to dot, 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 some positive term over here, plus dot, dot, dot. And so the physical processes over here are always going to be associated with positive perturbation pressure associated with fluid extension. Well, the physical processes going over here are zonal changes in the zonal component of motion, meridional changes in the meridional component of motion, and vertical changes in the vertical component of motion. Well, that's just stretching, where we have differences in the components of motion along the axes on which those vertical components of motion reside. Effectively, as we're going in the x direction over here, and we have increasing values of u in that same direction, or u prime, that's going to be associated with stretching processes. So over here on the right-hand side, we're dealing with lateral and vertical expansions and contractions. And wherever we have these expansions and contractions taking place, that's going to be associated with a positive perturbation pressure associated with nonlinear fluid extension. All right, so for instance, say we have an updraft, any updraft, whether it's that initial updraft or it's associated with the flanking updrafts that develop, we're going to have, say, an updraft over here. Beneath that updraft, we will have maximum, so this is W prime max. Beneath that maximum updraft over here, we're going to have stretching over here, max stretching. And over here, we're going to have maximum compression take place. And in each of those cases, we will have P prime NLFE is going to be greater than zero. P prime NLFE is also going to be greater than zero. And right here, where our maximum perturbation vertical velocity is, we will have no P prime NLFE, since we're at the maximum over here. You can think of some function over here where you have max extension over here, max extension over here, and then in between, we're having this relative minimum in the extension where the updraft perturbation vertical velocity is maximized. And that is going to be associated with a zero value for our P prime NLFE. And so what this is going to do is effectively, at looking along the vertical axis, along the flanks of our updraft over here, in other words, beneath it and above it, where we have non-zero values of, or positive values of P prime NLFE, we're going to have induced vertical motion. In this case, it's going to go from high to relatively lower perturbation pressure, like this, so beneath the maximum perturbation upward motion, and we'll have a downward induced motion beneath the P prime NLFE. But in terms of what's supporting convection, if you think about the vertical, where is our source region for convection? It's going to be where we have the highest theta E in the vertical. Effectively, what's driving the cape? It's relatively warm, moist conditions in the low levels. We've talked about that since the first day of classes. It's this couplet over here that is going to be relevant for supporting upward motion and for at the convective scale between the positive perturbation pressure resulting from stretching beneath the maximum vertical motion associated with that initial updraft. And that is going to be effectively what is going to be drawing that warm, humid air upward. That additional dynamical lifting is going to be supporting the lift of the warm, humid air down low. Parcels further are able to get to their LFCs through the stretching process over here, or since we have dynamical ascent occurring over here, and that is going to be associated with potential enhancements to the updraft as we have more lift occurring in the vicinity of the higher theta E air in the low levels compared to aloft. And so this is going to be the relevant part in particular for supporting enhancements to updrafts, as that is the source region down low of the higher theta E in the column relative to heights further aloft within the atmosphere. So regardless of whether we have background spin resulting from the either tilting of the horizontal vorticity, as we talked about with the straight hodograph, or potential ingestion of streamwise vorticity immediately into the vertical, supporting a vertically rotating updraft, a rotation about a vertical axis, which would further support this dynamical upward motion. We also get it occurring with any updraft, whether it's rotating or not, through this fluid extension term over here.